You probably clicked on that video because you feel empty, unwanted, apart, or simply lonely, and you want to know how to get rid of that feeling. Or maybe you just want to understand what's going on, or help somebody else. But no matter what it is, we got you covered. Hi, my name is Heiko. I'm a life coach. And especially right now, in times of lockdown, I got many clients who got problems with the feeling of loneliness. And because of that, I decided to create a series about the topic to help you to overcome that feeling and to prevent it in the future. Because now, in times of lockdown, won't be the only time we can feel lonely. It can happen in every stage of life, and it doesn't matter if you're single, in a relationship, or even famous. So you can kind of see it as a free online course in which we dive into the different aspects of loneliness in each video. You will learn how to overcome this feeling, what you shouldn't do when you feel lonely, how loneliness affects your health, and I will even give you some mindfulness tools that you can use as well. So if you don't want to miss out on these videos, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you get notified when we upload them. In this video, we will cover why we are experiencing the feeling of loneliness. This understanding will help us to overcome it, to prevent it in the future, and to help others who feel lonely. So let's get started. So why do we feel lonely? We must understand that this feeling is a message from our brain to take action and connect with others. We humans are social beings, and social interactions are part of who we are. In fact, we could only survive because we sticked and worked together and shared our knowledge with each other. So let's take a look way back to our ancestors. Back then, people lived in tribes, and that meant food, shelter, protection, and social interactions. Imagine you are part of a tribe and you have a fight with someone, or you get banned from the tribe because you didn't follow the rules. You will be in big trouble because, yes, you might find some eggs, some berries, or some shelter for a while, but at some point you would be struggling. There might be an animal attacking you or an enemy tribe. You might get injured or sick, and there won't be anybody there to help you, so your chance for survival would be very slim. But for that reason, our body gives us the signal of loneliness to bring us to reconnect to our tribe again and to get a shelter and protection again. And the feeling can get very strong and mentally painful to force us to do so, because after all, having an uncomfortable situation with your tribe to reconnect is still better than risking your life and dying, right? And don't forget that within the tribe, you can even cover some of your other needs like fun, love, and intimacy. So in a nutshell, loneliness is one of your body's tools to make sure you survive, which is easier in a group than alone. And the group environment also makes it more likely for you to reproduce, so that's a win-win situation. In our modern times, however, things are a bit different because we don't have to fight for survival anymore. We live in a time of abundance, and under normal circumstances, we don't struggle to find food or shelter anymore. We can do everything by ourselves and are not dependent on others. But there's a downside to this. Our brains have developed over hundreds of thousands of years, and they just didn't have the time to adapt to our new and independent lifestyle. Evolution is slow, and as a matter of fact, our new lifestyle makes it hard to spend time with others, because we are running from appointment to appointment, taking care of so many responsibilities, cleaning the house, laundry, buying groceries, food, all that kind of stuff. And that little time that we have left at the end of the day, we usually spend watching Netflix or distracting us with other medias instead of meeting someone. I mean, don't get me wrong, I do that too. It's so nice and easy to sit on the couch, relaxing, having a snack and watching a movie. And it's okay to do that from time to time. I'm not saying you have to say goodbye to Netflix, but it's not a long-term solution. And when we get out and meeting someone, we have to be mindful to not get distracted by technology as well. Oftentimes when people go out and they talk to each other, one of them takes out their phone and just have a look on it. But that can create a really weird feeling in the other person. Have you had it as well? Just by taking out the phone and looking on it, you can create a feeling of loneliness and insignificance in the other person, because we need to be heard, seen, and valued by others. I feel like when I hang out with friends and they take out their phone, I automatically take mine out as well. It's like we would enable each other's addictions. And so we end up in an endless loop of checking the phone and scrolling through the newsfeed instead of talking to each other. Do you know that feeling? I'm really curious about it. Please write in the comments below if you had situations like that and how you felt about it. So what does this all mean? It means that even though we face different situations than our ancestors, our bodies still react in the same way. We all can feel lonely for different reasons. Maybe you have been too busy for a while and you just need some social time with family and friends. Maybe you're looking more for an intimate connection. Or maybe you want a basic friendship or just somebody to talk to. Whatever the reason might be, the message is still the same. Connect with others. But please don't get me wrong. It doesn't mean that someone who is alone is automatically lonely. You can be thriving, happy, unfulfilled being alone, but hated to be in a group. It really depends on how you see your world and what kind of connections you need. For me, for example, I can feel really connected hanging out with friends and having some fun, but also just by being alone in nature and enjoying the scenery. So the first thing you can do to understand your feeling of loneliness is to identify what kind of connections you need. Do you need a deep relationship with someone, an intimate connection, or just someone to talk to? When did you feel lonely in the past, and what made you feel that way? And what helped you to come out of that feeling? Please take the time for yourself to identify what kind of connections you need. And if you have, please put it in the comments below. I'm so curious about it, and I will take the time to read all of your comments. And if you struggle to identify what kind of connections you need, you can book a free call for a conversation with me and I will help you out. So you will find the link for that in the description below. And that's it for this video. In the next one, we will talk about what you can do to overcome loneliness. So if you don't want to miss that out, subscribe and click the bell icon so you get notified when we upload it. Thank you for watching. I hope you found it helpful and I see you in the next video.